say?
The water is freezing and there aren't enough boats.
It was just an enormous undertaking. It set a bar for everybody.
God almighty.
And then, whammo.
We were the film that everybody wanted to see fail.
It was just this constant shelling, this constant bombardment.
These people had not read the script. These people had not seen a foot of dailies. These people had not visited our set.
A pretty vicious piece appeared referring to accidents that had happened on other shows and suggesting this too could be going on Titanic.
This little column, Titanic Watch, is running on the front page of Variety every single day.
Detailing the latest disasters, where the budget was.
And this is going on while we're trying to make the film.
The editing room was my bunker. I taped a razor blade to the screen of my Avid, and I wrote on it, use in case film sucks.
Once we got our trailer out there, the tides turned a bit.
I was seeing something else, and suddenly the trailer came on for Titanic. My hair just stood up on the back of my neck. I couldn't believe what I was seeing.
They had convinced me that the movie could not make any money. My career was over. I probably would never get to direct again, but I was gonna go down swinging.
We went over to Japan, we premiered the film there, and the reaction was overwhelming.
Crowds were going crazy. It was like the Beatles. It was insane.
When the reviews came in, we were stunned. They were so good. I'd never gotten anything like the kind of reviews that I got for Titanic.
And we had to worry about the world premiere in England. How would the reaction be in England, where the ship had sailed from? And the audience wept. That's when we said, we have a chance.
It did well that first weekend.
But we were only number one that weekend by the tiniest margin. They practically had to do a recount.
Next weekend, it grossed more.
What? That doesn't happen. That never happened. And then the next weekend, it went up again.
I don't think anyone had the notion it would inspire multiple viewings beyond maybe a teenage girl audience. We were in love with Leo at the time.
Everybody wanted to outdo each other. Well, no, I've seen it 17 times, or I've seen it 55 times.
I met a guy, and he'd seen it something like 80-odd times. That's like sitting in a cinema for a week.
Parents were taking kids. Adult kids were taking their parents. It was this transgenerational sharing kind of experience.
But Titanic just kept going up.
People were saying, this is a film that might even get to $1 billion, something that was unheard of.
It was basically number one in every country it was released in. It was playing across language, societal, cultural, and religious barriers.
Even communist China has given the most expensive, highest-grossing film of all time the official seal of approval.
The film had a huge impact internationally.
That's when we realized it was this phenomenon. And then the phenomenon just didn't stop.
The song really had its own life.
The distillation of everything you've gone through in the film, you take away this little remembrance as a keepsake.
Hearing it brought those emotions back. If you had seen the film, it brought them back.
I heard about girls having crying parties where they would listen to the song over and over and cry at all the right places. And
you could hear it everywhere. You'd be sitting next to people on the bus and they'd be humming it.
It wasn't until the night we win the Oscar that the pressure that we had been living under for 3+ years was off our shoulders.
It was an amazing night because nothing is given, nothing is taken for granted.
I'm really proud of the film. I'm really proud of what everybody did.
Take it to see Mr. Murdoch. Let's stretch your legs.
Yes, sir.
It's an important film to people. People still remember it.
I'm the king of the world!
I've been looking for years for an opportunity to put Titanic back on the big screen. I always felt that the centenary of the real sinking would be a perfect opportunity. Put the 3D on top of that, and it really kicks it up to a whole other level.
Let go of my hand.
I'll never let go.